Curious to know, it's not like there's no Indians. There are 7 Indians in our batch, 3 boys, 4 girls, excluding me. So I am a girl, okay. So I'm the 8th person in that. So total 8 with me. So what I'm gonna tell you is, like, slowly, even in the first year, it was a foundation year, a competitive year where we have to compete, and out of 1,000 people, only 250 people were selected. 250 people were selected, okay? And thanks to God, I was one of them. So in that competitive phase, no one was there with me. I am a very close person with my mom, okay? Without my mom, I don't even eat. Till the day I went to college, my mom only fed me. Okay, she even feeds me. Without her lap, I cannot do. I was that kind of a person. So suddenly when I went back, when I went to college, every day I used to cry. Like, especially when I had those mood swings and all those things, I used to cry. I used to feel like, you know, I feel like I lost out and no one is my friend, or I don't have a social life. I don't have anyone to talk with, and I was in a separate room. Okay, so think how it might have been. So what I'm suggesting you is, mentally prepare yourself. I know many of you might have close relationship with your parents, or you are ready to fly already, okay? So it depends on, that's very good, I'm not commenting on anything, but I am like this, okay? This was my journey, personally. So the next thing that I would tell is, no attachments. Always remember, school life is different from college life. In school, you are you have a sentiment thing where you have your friends and all these things. You know, you have teachers. If you both fight, if you both pull your hair and fight also, your teachers will come in between. Stop, okay? And they will take you to the principal ma'am, VP ma'am, someone, and the fight will be solved. Something like this will happen. But in college, friends are not what they show. People are not what they show, okay? I'm not telling don't trust anyone. Be happy, enjoy, speak with, now I don't know who you are, but I'm speaking like as if I know every one of you, okay? So, honestly, I was very scared sitting there, okay? But when I'm speaking, that's it. So, I don't know who you are, I'm speaking nicely, but after I go out, I'm not going to remember any one of you. This is how you should be in college. You speak with everyone, enjoy with everyone, should think that you are so many best friends, okay? Some people even say that I know the whole college, I don't know who is what. They have some big titles. They come to me, they'll be like, you remember me, I saw you that day. I'll be like, yeah, I remember you, but I don't know who they are. I don't know their names, I don't remember anything, okay? Yeah. Because medical terms are more than what their names, okay? So I have to remember that, I cannot remember this. So, yeah. So, the main point is, have college life separate from your home. When you come inside your home, study, do your extracurricular activities, sing, if you have any music, instruments, games, do anything. But don't bring the emotions to your home. For example, you help, and also you help someone, okay? Don't expect, if you are helping because your conscience is asking you to help, okay? Your conscience is telling you that help him, please. So you are doing that for your satisfaction of conscience, okay? You're not doing because he is actually in trouble. So do it for your conscience and be happy, leave, that's it. Don't be like, you know, that day I was in trouble, he didn't help me, I helped him because he was in trouble. No. If you want, you help, you leave, that's it. Don't ask anyone that, don't expect, that's it. Don't expect in return, favor. Do and be happy, that's it. And also the next is, yeah, make your own space. And then, very important, self-control. Very important. There was a thing, how do you balance social life? And there was a question who asked this, okay? Who was that? I forgot. Yeah, exactly. So there was a question, how do you balance social life and studies? Now I will tell you that. Self-control and saying no. This too is very important thing. And for those beautiful and extraordinary and awesome backbenchers, I know it's a very difficult task for you to say no. And self-control, both, okay? Once you start playing, you play for the whole year. Once you start studying, you don't do that, okay? So what I'm telling you is, you should know where to say no, where to stop, and where to start studying. Okay, if you're playing, play, no problem, it's not wrong. I also use Instagram when I was in 12th, I used everything, okay? I also see reels, enjoy, smile, laugh, everything. I also went for so many competition and stuff. But I also scored well. I also understood when I studied well. When I enjoyed well. I know the balance between both. If I'm playing, I play for, if I play for 2 hours, for example, that exactly after, when I fix that I'm going to study at 5:30, I start at 5:30. I don't procrastinate it. I'm like, okay, one more hour now. It's okay, one more hour, it will become 12:30. 12:30, you will start. 3 o'clock, you will, for namesake, you will study, sleeping. And then nothing is going to go into your head and that's it. So this is not the way. You need self-control. You need to say no when you have to say no. It not only applies to studies, but also it applies to the people you are with. For example, in my college life, I was alone. The room, I said, I'm alone in my room. So there was a boy who said that we all, girls and boys, are, he was senior to me. He said that we all are going outside for an outing. Okay, honestly, my parents trust me a lot. They will never tell no. I didn't even ask my mom, okay, about this. But I told them about this, but I didn't ask them permission. He said that, Sandhya, come, let's, how will you always stay in that room and keep studying? Let's go out, Sandhya, come on. I was like, okay, but I don't have time. I cannot come outside. I don't want to go. It's fine, no problem. I don't want to come. And he was like, you know, come. And then I was like, my mom will not allow me. I just told him that. And he was like, how will your mom know where you're going? This is the question he asked me. How will your mom know where you're going? If you tell only, she'll know. Na? Don't tell, just come. This is what he said. And I observed his character and I was like, I'm sorry, I'm not coming. This is not my ethics. This is not according to my principle, my ethics. I'm not going to change for you. Yeah, so I was like, I'm sorry, I'm not coming. That's it. If you insist me to come, then I'm sorry, I'm blocking you. That's it. Okay, yeah. So this is how I was. Okay, so you should know where to tell no and self-control. And the last thing, I don't know how many of you will go to India, but when we go to India, we have that NRI thing, okay? Yeah, I know, okay? We have that NRI tag. Because I went to India, I was in Pearl School, 7th standard 2015, first semester of Pearl School, I finished, and then I went to India. I went to a school, and you know the style over here, you're protected by parents, you go in a luxury car, yeah? You have a car with you, not luxury car, at least medium car, Corolla, Nissan, something you will have, okay? So in that car you will go and come, your papa will drop you and he will leave you at house, you know? So this is how it is. But in India, you have to walk, you have to drive bicycle, you have to... some of you might know bikes. You have to do your work by yourself, okay? And your parents will be so much involved with your relatives, relatives issue. So you have to take care of yourself. And even if you're going to college, your parents might not come with you. You have to go alone, yeah? So you should be with yourself and you should know to tackle yourself, your problems all by yourself. And I will also tell, don't share your inner feelings with anyone. No one is that worth it to know what you're feeling inside. Learn, practice to share your problems with yourself. That is the most important thing. I know this sounds so stupid, but even I'm practicing this. This is how you do, like writing a diary, or I just stand in front of the mirror and start screaming at me. This is what I do. This is my trick. You can just think of something else that you want, but I don't share my feelings with anyone. I just stand in front of the mirror, start screaming there. Okay, I start talking to myself. So that is a very important thing. And yeah, and if you're going as an NRI, I know some people might be very happy that, you know, like they will be like, oh, you came from Doha? That kind of, okay? Dubai? Oh my God. They will give you that. So, you know, suddenly, you know, your heart will go to cloud 9 and you'll be like, yeah, I'm from Doha, and you will start flexing. Please don't do that, okay? Because they just need one opportunity to throw you down, okay? When you do that, the next moment they will throw you out of their group. They'll not even include you anywhere. They will start sidelining you. That's what I've written over there. Be a Roman when you're in Rome. However they are, if they are very simple, down-to-earth kind of people, be like that. Don't try to be the highest, like NRI kind of a person. Go with a high attitude, with a Gucci bag or whatever it is. Don't Adidas shoes, no. Just, I'm not telling you don't wear, but don't show off, that's it. Just be normal, you know, like them. Just speak in Hindi, yeah, chalna yaar, kya hai. Be like that, okay? Be very simple, happy. I'll just go with the flow and don't go up to cloud nine. And I hope that's it about this. Can you just go ahead, please? boards and preparation, they have spoke already. I don't have to give